As many of you know, all of us here are homeschool moms. And with that comes one of the biggest questions every homeschool family asks: which curriculum will we be using this year? Brittany, starting with you, how does your family choose a curriculum?
You like this. Oh, that's what we're going to be doing this year. We, first of all, look for a Bible-based curriculum. Yeah. You don't have to. It's what we like. Just works for us. And then I get references. Mm-hmm. And then I just try it.
Yeah.
And so we use a curriculum called My Father's World. We love it. And it's just worked for us. Mm-hmm. But that's what I recommend you do. Ask around. Mm-hmm. See what other people are using. See what way you want to go. If you want more hands-on, less hands-on, whatever that looks like. It comes in every shape and size. And then, but it's just what worked for us. And yeah, we love it. How about you guys?
Well, I've switched it up almost every year, except for the first 2 years. So I love My Father's World. I'm trying a couple new ones this year. Actually, Jameson will be doing three different curriculums for different subjects, because now I kind of have a better idea of how he's learning, what's going to interest him. Like, the science that we got this year is zoology, which he's going to like. Die over. He's gonna love that. So he gets to learn about. So just kind of like picking a curriculum. It is a faith-based. It's called Master Books. So just kind of trying out new things.
Right.
Now I will say that I tried out something new last year and it failed miserably and I stopped using it halfway through the year. So just be prepared that you might be spending a little bit of money and losing it. But overall, I feel like the trial and error for me has been kind of the best way to learn and then know, okay, now I know how a few of them work so that going forward with the other kids, a lot of it that I've already bought, I'm going to use again, obviously. Right. But like, okay, well, maybe she learns this way, so let me try that or for this subject. So that's how we do it.
I like the thing with homeschooling that I really enjoy is the creativity. If you're creative like me, when they're little, I don't do a curriculum for kindergarten. I do my own preschool. I do my own thing. I just go to wherever. You can go to any store and get the my big book of kindergarten, preschool, first grade. And it's just what you enjoy. I really enjoy teaching my kids to read myself. I love teaching them their letters. I love watching them memorize the sounds and then going into the language and the parts of speech part of it. I really enjoy that. So for me, it's been really fun to kind of put together my own things. My favorite age is preschool and kindergarten, because I feel like once you hit first grade, you have to kind of get a little bit deeper and a little bit more serious. And My Father's World is great for our family because it has everything that you could imagine in one box.
It
just tells you, it's very easy because it just the scheduling on it is just so simple. Monday, math, and it just tells you, go to this book, open it up. So that's what we like to do.
Yeah, I would say that. I agree with that. I am not, well, I did it last year with history, but I am not typically a prepare your own lesson. I want someone else to tell me what to do. Just because there are so many options that on my own I could not narrow it down or begin to teach a lesson. But I love what you said. I feel like the thing that I found most important was asking other people. There's most likely a homeschool Facebook page in the area that you live in. We had one in Chester County. We found one where we moved to in Florida. So most likely you have people that have done it longer and have had more experience. And it's great to talk to people because there are a bazillion options. It's overwhelming. I remember that it took me 2 years. And that may be ridiculous or sound ridiculous, but it took me 2 years I spent those 2 years talking to people.
Yeah.
Because there was just so much
true.
I was like, I can't. So I would say that's the biggest thing, is just talk to people and
But on the other side of that, be confident to do your own thing.
Yeah.
Because I think you get to a point with homeschooling where you just have to jump in and be like, you know what, I'm gonna try this. Yeah. If it doesn't work, we'll switch it up next year.
Yeah.
And not be afraid to kind of take that plunge. I mean, I think people are fantastic resources, but they also don't know how your family works. So I think that you have to keep that in mind. Like, there were, you know, there were nights that or days that we did not do anything until my husband came home from work and I could say, oh, please take the younger two. I'm gonna go in the dining room with Jameson and get school done. So we would take until bedtime to do school, and it just worked for us because we would have all day. So don't be afraid to like play around with things that work for your family.
Yeah. And you have your own strengths and weaknesses. So for me, I am the last person on the planet that you ever want to be around math and teaching your children math.
Me too.
And I know that. I know that I look at the, even first grade, I'm like, I don't get it. I'm looking in the back for the answer, so I pass that up to Paul. Mm-hmm. So Paul gets to do the math, and that's kind of a bonding thing with the boys and their dad. So you don't have to be good at it all.
Yeah.
Just
yeah.
know your strength yes, strengths and weaknesses,
sure.
I would say.
I'm not good at math either. We're going to go online for math.
100%.
Because that's not always fun. But yeah, I think I've even heard of, we were doing a co-op one year, and I heard a mom who was like a full-time working mom that had her mom come during the day, and she homeschooled her kids when she got home from work. That's dedication.
Wow. Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
like, so you can be flexible with both curriculum, with your time, to kind of really just incorporate for your family.
Yep. It doesn't have to look one way.
Exactly. When it comes to homeschooling curriculum, there is not one size fits all. figuring out your family's non-negotiables is the key to selecting the best fit. Thanks for joining us. If you enjoyed this video, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Instagram and Facebook. You can also access our content through the FISM app. Download it today by clicking the link below or visit fism.tv to learn more.